He's got a voice like solid gold and a twinkle in his eye. And keeping that eye firmly placed on our parliamentarian buddies is Tony Amos. We welcome Tony and the weekly political roundup.
Tony Amos, the...
Jared Smith, how are you?
Very good, Tony, very good.
Good to see you.
The start of another week.
Another big week in paradise, aren't we the lucky ones? We live in the greatest country in the world. And it's the beginning of the second last month of the year, isn't that a great...
Yeah, but you've been busy last week. You had a day out with your daughter. That was a wonderful little trip, wasn't it?
I did indeed, with my youngest daughter. We did a school trip. It was called a school trip. And I was one of the proud dads. And the mums, some mums went as well, and dads and teachers. And we walked across Tauranga Harbour. We literally walked right across the harbour.
Low tide, obviously.
To Matakana Island. Yeah. From a point near Katikati. Across at low tide, through the mud and through some of the water, and it was an amazing experience.
Gosh.
Quite incredible. And then we walked down around part of the island as well, met some of the locals. Of course, the best part of the experience, it was me and my 10-year-old Tasman, because it was her school trip, and to see all the other children having a good time as well. A bit of adventure, but a great thing to do. So my advice to anyone, if you're a dad or a mum or a grandma or a granddad, if you get a chance to go on a school trip and see all that energy, all that joy, do it when you can.
Yeah. Oh, good advice, Tony, but I suppose that you were so busy you lost track of all the goings-on in Parliament this week.
Yes, politics, the global gutter of life, the rooters and looters of public office we call our parliamentarians. There's been a bit going on, hasn't there?
Oh, hasn't there?
And there's been a bit happening here with our Rodney Hyde-led coalition government. Yes, well, shonky jonky's always out of the country, so I guess someone's got a lead. So this time, it's Rodney's thick hide. Or Shallow Yellow, as he's known to his mates, both of them. And of course, he's in trouble, Rodney. What's he in trouble for? Well, the great perk buster has been busted for perking it up. Yes, it's come to light that Rodney's thick hide, the man who's telling us all we shouldn't be wasting taxpayer money, we need to tighten our belts, all that stuff, he's been busted for taking his latest girlfriend on a trip halfway around the world that has cost the taxpayers around $25,000. Yeah, 25 grand in hard-earned taxpayer money. Outrageous stuff.
Tony, you know, there's one good thing out of this. One, it's taken all the heat off Bill.
Bill English, otherwise known as the double-dipping dipstick from Dipton. Of course, now, well, he's branching out into television on the digital channel, so he's now known as the, officially known as the digital double-dipping dipstick from Dipton. And again, he's shown poor judgment. This time, he's taken what's to all intents and purposes a party political broadcast onto Television New Zealand as a promo for TVNZ. Now, this man is the Minister of Finance, the Deputy Prime Minister, and of course, one of the shareholding ministers in TVNZ. And they're clearly sucking up to Bill. Well, they've clearly heard the word that National have a plan now to sell off TVNZ. That's right, they're going to privatise Television New Zealand. But the point is here that while Bill English says it was TVNZ's idea and he really had nothing to do with it, he made the decision to go on. And once again, the digital double-dipping dipstick from Dipton has made a very poor judgment call. And anyway, we're sick of that long-winded name. We'd much prefer now just to know him as Bullshit Bill.
Well, we're going to move from the Parliament, politics, we're now into religion. Things are happening in that area.
Brian Tamaki, and he's now got 700 members of his church, so-called church, who call themselves his sons, and they have committed themselves to being totally in support of him. Whatever he says rules, whatever he does rules, they're not allowed to argue with him, and they must stand up when he enters the room, and if they're having a meal, they can't start eating before he does. I mean, this is a man who's outrageously stupid, in my humble opinion. If you take the path of Christianity, if you take the path of Jesus Christ, Jesus apparently was a humble man. Would he approve? I think not. Brian Tamaki, mate, you've got a bit to learn here. Is it a religion? It's a sect or a cult?
Well, Tony, from the king to the kingmakers, all our mates in Parliament.
Oh, yes, the oddballs and misfits. Yes,
our
parliamentarians and the List MPs in particular. Remember the List MPs? They're the members of Parliament that nobody voted for. Anyway, there's a story about a List MP. This particular List MP and his wife went on a trip to Jerusalem, no doubt at taxpayers' expense. But sadly, whilst they were there, the List MP's wife suddenly died. And he was shocked, of course. And anyway, he had to go through the protocols and he spoke to the local funeral director. And the funeral director said, look, you've got an option here, Mr. List MP. He said, you can have your wife buried here for just $150 here in the Holy Land, or you can have her transported home, fly her home for a cost of $5,000. Which would you prefer? And the list MP thought about it for a moment, and then he looked at the undertaker, and he smiled and he said, I think I'll have her flown home. The undertaker said, why would you spend $5,000 flying her home when you could have her buried here in the Holy Land for just $150? And he looked at the funeral director and he said, well, he said, years ago, a man died here in Jerusalem and they buried him. But 3 days later, he arose from the dead. And I'm afraid I just can't take that chance. That's politics. Remember, never turn your back on a politician.
Tony Amos. Thanks, Dave. He's out.